In this video, we perform a 3-in-1 polarity, insertion loss, and return loss test in OPL-Max. Using the OP415 Polarity Analyzer and the OP940 Insertion Loss and Return Loss Meter. Once we confirm that the units have power and are connected to the computer through USB, we can boot up OPL-Max to begin. First, we must choose the correct configuration for our test. In this case, verification of the polarity of a 12-fiber Type A cable, followed by insertion loss and return loss for that same cable. We begin our test by taking the return loss reference. Our aim is to find the distance from the front panel of the OP940 where we want to measure return loss from later. Since this distance will be the same for each of the 12 channels, we can copy the distance found for channel 1 to the others, vastly decreasing the duration of this step. Before we start the insertion loss reference, we connect the open end of the fanout to the detector. Specifically, we connect to the integrating sphere that allows us to use one detector to capture light from all 12 fibers of the MTP cable. The pause step window we see here has no effect on the referencing, since we do not reference for the polarity test, but it will come in handy later. The insertion loss reference allows us to isolate the loss of the device under test by comparing the amount of loss on each channel before and after it is introduced to the setup. All 12 channels must be referenced individually for insertion loss in order to determine the before values, as these will vary from channel to channel. With the referencing completed, we designate a file to save our results to and move on to testing. The DUT is connected to the OP415 for the polarity test. This window shows that the mapping of the fibers in the cable matches the Type A mapping it was tested against. Had it failed, we could abort the test here. Since it passed, we move our cable to the OP940 and continue to the insertion loss and return loss test. The pause step window we ignored earlier gives us time to move the cable. Even though the cable passed polarity, good insertion loss and return loss is not guaranteed. There are many factors that can impact the performance of a cable. Being able to quickly perform all three of these tests expedites the identification of issues and the isolation of their root causes. A test report can be generated for both passing and failing cables, serving as a record of the test that was just performed.